Wel, we houden even op met al dit gezang, want we hebben op het ogenblik hebben wij mensen in de studio die hier op bezoek zijn. Maar in feite waren ze in het auditorium hier voor een bijeenkomst. En daar wil ik even heel kort iets over zeggen, want er kwam een hele bekende naam voor en dat zijn de Molukken. En zodoende dacht ik ineens, hé, dat heeft een Nederlandse connectie. En zodoende is er iemand hier bij ons die heeft... Op een bepaalde manier is hij naar Australië gekomen met zijn zoon. Hij spreekt een klein beetje Nederlands, want hij is vroeger op school geweest. Dus ik spreek van nu dan Engels met hem. Good evening, we have here father and son together. And what's your name?
John Peter Suiza.
John Peters
and Suiza.
And Paul Bastian Suiza.
Bastian, that sounds very Dutch. Bastian. En zij zijn hier op dit moment voor de Independence Day of de Molukken.
Yes.
En they had een, they had films and other things and speakers to talk about this. But in the meantime, they also live in Australia. Yeah, you both do.
Yeah.
And can you please tell me? You made it from your country to Australia in a very special way. You went by ship.
Coba jelaskan bagaimana Anda sampai ke Australia. Apakah Anda sampai Australia dengan kapal perahu?
Ya, saya datang ke Australia dengan kapal motor ikan. Fishing fishing boat. Boat fishing boat.
I came to Australia with a fishing boat.
Yeah.
Dus zij kwamen naar Australië per vissersboot en they took more people with them, is it? You had more people on board.
Anda datang dengan dengan kapal di Australia dengan beberapa orang di perahu, betul?
Ya, yeah, betul. 53 orang termasuk saya, 54.
Ya, yeah, benar. 53 orang termasuk saya, 54 orang. So 53 people, including me, 54 people.
And how old were you at that time?
Me at the time I was 18 years old.
18 years yes. old. You still look 18.
Thank you.
Is it a long time ago?
yeah. It's been 19 years now.
Yeah. And was it very dangerous?
Apa sangat berbahaya?
Ya, sangat berbahaya. Waktu di laut banyak gelombang besar. Yeah. Karena saya dengan kapal yang kecil bisa mengarungi samudra.
So yes, it's a very dangerous journey at the time because we were using the small boat and that's a
Is that
international
seaworthy
yeah.
the boat?
Oh yes, a lot of sick, of course, you know, because small boat is not supposed to be
have so many people aboard.
Yeah, it's 54 of us would be. Yeah,
it reminds me of like what's happening now with the Mediterranean, where people come from Africa to Italy. But this is a longer distance, I suppose.
Yeah, longer distance. Basically 100 miles from Maluku to Darwin, but then because small boat, it took us longer to get here.
Much longer. So
five
days. Your destiny at that time was Darwin.
Because small boat.
Yeah.
Hukum internasional Geneva.
Yeah.
Tidak boleh small boat tidak boleh mengarungi samudra. Laut samudra.
So Geneva international law for small boat cannot be to the international. Yeah.
You can't have that many people aboard.
Yeah.
I suppose that's not really legal.
That's right.
Yeah. And your father, he was the navigator. He was the
correct.
The steward.
He's the captain of the boat.
The steerman.
The captain.
Yeah. And what happened at the end with the boat?
Bagaimana itu dengan itu kapal sekarang, kira-kira?
Kapal sekarang itu ditahan sama pemerintah Australia di Darwin.
So the Australian government held the boat in Darwin.
Yeah.
That's a history.
Yeah. So and all those people stayed in Australia. The 54.
Apakah
people?
Semua orang yang datang itu tinggal di Australia?
Tidak. Pemerintah Australia, Perdana Menteri John Howard, sama Menteri Luar Negeri Alexander Donner, sudah berbicara dengan kita untuk tinggal di Australia. Tapi 39 orang itu terpengaruh oleh satu orang dari orang Manado tapi tinggal di Ambon. Dia pengaruh anak-anak itu pulang karena dia kena suap sama duta besar Indonesia yang ada di Canberra.
I think you have to stop here to otherwise you might forget which.
So they the Australian government already gave opportunity to change the 39 people who got divided from
over various areas.
Yeah, from 54 to 15 and 39.
Yeah.
So but then they chosen to go back to our homeland. Because one of they go they've got manipulated by one person who got bribed by the Indonesian embassy in Darwin at the time. He got paid off US
even
dollars.
Even there it happens.
Yeah.
Yeah, unfortunately. Yeah. And your country is still looking for independence.
Yes.
Yeah, you're not independent as yet.
It's
under Indonesia.
Under Indonesia at the moment, yeah. Yeah. Haven't been recognition by the world, even though we are the proclamation.
Yeah, looking for the United Nations.
Yeah, as a recognition. Yeah.
Other things, and that's why you had this meeting here together.
Yeah, basically our anniversary celebration of our independence on the April 25th since 1950.
Yeah, if that happens, would you go back?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Look after our people and our homeland.
Okay.
We have 1,024 islands, big and small.
How many?
1,024 island big and small.
That's enormous.
Yeah, and many oil, gas, gold. If the government Dutch help me, for freedom,
I think everybody would like to help you.
Yeah, because my country many mineral, and I talk for the government Dutch for the ugly mineral for come join with me, yeah, and people and Dutch come to my country, live in my country.
Live in peace.
It's good.
It's very good. Yeah. It sounds good.
It's good.
Do you get many tourists there as well?
Oh yes, we got many tourists. Last time tourists that came to Maluku with the cruise ship, I think it was back in 2012. But still coming, like one of my partner went there for tourists there.
Yeah.
Look around the archipelago. It's too big to go around in every single island. 1,024 islands, that's too much.
No, you can't do it in one trip.
But how do you communicate? You need lots of boats.
Yeah.
Together.
And transmigration from Java, Sukarno, transmigration, come from Java, Muslim. Before, Muslim in my country, 10%. And Christian, Catholic, United Church, 90%.
So 10% before is Muslim.
Muslim, but it's life is good, yeah?
Life is good.
But transmigration can trouble.
Monique, have you been there around in
No, not yet. Our plan is to go.
Connections.
Yeah. Our plan is to go next year. So, very interesting.
Next year. That will be good.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
But okay. I think if the government does help me, freedom, I'm freedom. Saya butuhkan tenaga ahli dari Belanda untuk membangun Maluku.
I will ask for Dutch government to supply the
Belanda,
good engineer, so we can helping each other out.
Well, anyway, we wish you, of course, success with your mission. Hope that everything it goes well for you, and thank you so much to be able to talk here in the studio to us.
Saya harap,
and
saya,
to translate.
Yeah, I hope you talk for government that's for help me. Pesan dari John Peter Suisa, High Commando Republic Maluku. If government Dutch mau membantu kita merdeka,
to be independent.
Independent, kita kekayaan alam banyak.
We will work together.
How many people are living there?
I'm not sure now. It's a lot of transmigration came from Java Island and stuff like that. So not now. I'm lost. Lost counting.
5 million or?
No, 1 million.
Before 1 million, now is more. Now more.
The transmigration came 2 million, 3 million, I don't know.
Okay.
It's politics.
Well, I wish you all the best.
Yeah.
And thanks once again.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you so
much.
Thank you
very much.
Danke wel.
Danke.
Danke wel.
I should leave.
Thank you.
I ek naar huis.
I'll ring you when I'm
because